So in this video, I want to talk about inner confidence and outer confidence mainly. So a lot of people either go down one route or down the other, and they don't realize they go mostly hand in hand. You need inner confidence as well as outer confidence, the external. So the three ways that I would say mainly just straight up how you build confidence is you got to do things that scare you, do things that are uncomfortable. Like, I've never delivered a masterclass before. Is it uncomfortable? Kind of. It's a little bit weird. I'm going to do it anyway. The second point I have for you is start doing new things. Stop saying no to things that you should start saying yes to. Now, obviously, don't become a yes man. Just say yes to everything because you'll burn yourself out. You'll have no time for yourself. If someone says, hey, do you want to go rock climbing? Hey, do you want to start this new hobby? Hey, do you want to give this a try? Just say yes and go along with it. You'll notice the most cultured people, the most confident people have been out there and done things. They've traveled a bit. They've done exciting things with their life. So it's time to stop saying no to everything and start trying a few new things. It doesn't mean you have to go instantly like I did in this next clip when I was 19 and I went straight in with the confidence of I'm gonna do a fucking skydive and that's gonna make me the most confident human in the world. It didn't. It boosted me a little bit, but it wasn't the be all and end all. I came away from that thinking, well, where's this confidence I'm supposed to be feeling? It was great, don't get me wrong. I would love to do it again. You know, it was a one-off thing and it was something that made me realize that I'm gonna have to do this again and again and again in various circumstances in order to boost my confidence. And the last thing I would say is apply some pressure. Most people are way too scared to do anything uncomfortable, to do anything that remotely requires them to think a little bit, to do something outside the box. Diamonds are made under pressure. Diamonds are made under pressure. If you don't apply pressure to your life, if you don't do something that, you know, forces you a little bit, that you're like, oh, I don't like quite like this, I don't like this. If you don't do something like that, you're not gonna get far in the confidence world. So I'm gonna start with the outer confidence first. So the first thing I want you to watch is your body. Now, a lot of you have probably heard of using your body language to portray something. You'll have noticed already I use my hands a lot, but it's kind of like the head, shoulders, knees, and toes thing. Like, watch your head, keep your head up, keep your eyes, you know, eye contact. Don't be looking down and like, hunch shoulders and talking so quietly and standing like this. If you wanna be confident, express it through your body. So chest out, head up. Don't be a carpet fitter like this. Confident, shoulders back, head up. Talk straight to people. It's amazing what body language can pick up on. Now, a funny thing that I know a lot of people do is when they are out socially, for example, this kind of all blurs away. People somehow forget to be confident and they start to like panic a little bit. One cool thing you can do if you wanna be aware of this is if you've got a drink in your hand, a lot of people will kind of hold it here. They kind of have this closed off chest, right? It's almost like a barrier between you and the other person. I tend to go for a bottle if I'm drinking anything and I'll kind of have it down by my side and I'll leave this bit open because if you stand like this, what does it tell the other person? There's a barrier between you. I'm not really fussed. I'm kind of like, yeah, I'm a little bit aggressive towards you. I'm a little bit like hostile. I'm a little bit wary of you and things like that. So you want to kind of avoid that closed off body language. You want to be open, you want to be expressive, you want to move a bit, you want to be more authentic, you don't just want to stand there and be really, really dull. When it comes to confidence, you want to be able to express it through your body, through your hand movements, through your openness, and people will really like that. People will love the fact that you are open, they can come to you, and it just makes them feel more comfortable with you. The second tip for outer confidence I have is use your vocal tonality. What you'll tend to find is, a lot of the time you'll meet people and they're kind of just like monotone and there's no inflection to the way they speak. They're kind of like, oh, like this. And you'll probably know people like that. If you want to be confident and express confidence to other people, use your vocal range. If you're going to go high, if you're going to go low, if you're going to, you know, go vary between the two, you'll notice I do that a lot. I do inflections, I do whatever else, right? Using your vocal range is key. Now, you don't want to be overly loud and really dominate every situation, right? There's a couple of guys in the gym I go to that really piss me off, right? They probably don't even know they're doing it. It's probably just in their nature now to do it. But they laugh so loud as if they want everyone else to hear it. They talk so loud, they just talk over everyone. I'm like this with my headphones, like, shut the fuck up. Like, you are so annoying and you don't want to be that guy. That's the arsehole way, right? And a lot of the time people think it's you know, alpha or confident or whatever you want to call it, but it's not. It's an arsehole. So you can be loud, you can be, you know, fun, but you have to be also like aware that you don't have to overdo it. You kind of get that sweet spot. Another thing that's great, like if you suffer with a lot of social anxiety, best thing you can do for this, and this is such a good tip, slow your voice down. Unconfident people try and speak really fast. Slow it down. Speak clear. Let people know that you're listening. You're responding, not reacting to what they're saying. And when you slow down and you give people your attention, people will notice that you actually are there. You're present. And it's a massive change in energy. So if you are feeling anxious, slow down the way that you talk. Don't slow it down to a whisper or that it's creepy, but slow it down to a point where you're like, cool, awesome. I think we should go get a drink. I think we should go try this. What do you think? Slow it down. You'll notice this in movies as well. They speak very slow. People that, when you speak slow, people hang on your every word. Because unconfident people don't think they're gonna get to the end of the sentence. They try and ram everything out. They're like, blah, 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 blah. So me, I did this, blah, 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 blah. And you're like, whoa, fucking hell. Settle down. Like, don't rab it on and rab it on and rab it on and try and get it all in, because that's not confident behavior. And the third outer confidence tip is your calibration. So you learn how to read social cues. Now, I have a brother with autism and he really struggles with this. He doesn't really understand social cues. It was something that I myself had to learn. And you'd be surprised how often people just ignore social cues. It's all about them. It's all about how they feel. And basically what a social cue is, learning whether something is appropriate to do or not do, to say or not say. So for example, you'll know that you wouldn't blast Iron Maiden at a funeral, right? You would know this. You wouldn't laugh at a funeral. You just wouldn't do that. It's not an appropriate time to do that. So you're reading the other person's body. You're making it less about you and more about a win-win situation. You're calibrated to the situation. You understand what's required of you. You aren't the same person in every situation. I'm calibrated. I'm not this big gobshite that's gonna overly dominate the room for no reason other than to satisfy my own ego. It's not about me. Sometimes it's not about you. Sometimes it's about the other person, and you have to be aware of that. You have to be calibrated to the situation. Like when you go into, say you were going to go to a nightclub, I don't know how many of you go to nightclubs recently or bars or whatever, people are there for what reason? To have fun. You start talking to them about stupid shit that they're not interested in, or moaning and bitching, you're ruining the night. Get away. You're not calibrated to the situation. You might think people don't care, but it's because you picked the wrong time to say the wrong thing. That's it. Calibration takes a while. There are many books on this. And one of the best ones I ever read was a book called Models by Mark Manson. Yes, it's a dating book, but it's also very key for reading social situations, learning the right behavioral patterns if you're interested in that. So moving on to the inner confidence, how do you build that inner self-esteem and sense of self-worth? Well, the first thing, is you wanna try and build a great lifestyle. If you're already living a great life, you'll notice that your confidence massively improves. Your happiness levels are up, you feel great, and you'll start to notice more opportunities in your life than you would if you were miserable and just doing the same thing day in and day out. It's a sense of adventure. It's a sense of having your health together. It's a sense of trying new things. As I said earlier, you don't want to be lazy. You want to put effort into your life. One way you can do this, if you're like, well, I work a lot, I do a lot of hours or whatever. Here's one way you can build a great life during that. Build a great sense of self-esteem. Be the best at your job. Get in earlier, stay later. That's what I used to do. My previous job before this was a waiter at TGI Fridays. I was one of the best there. And that's not an ego thing. That's me hand on heart saying I was fucking mint at that job. I was so good. I had such good people skills. I had such good care and attention because I wanted to be, you know, I wanted to do it not just for myself, but for the place. I had a sense of responsibility, sense of loyalty. And what that gave me was a sense of confidence that, yeah, I'm really good at this. I know what I'm doing. I can do this. I can, you know, I have a sense of self-worth around this. You know, I could go on forever on this, but if you put the most effort into your job, most people won't do that. Most people just do enough just to get by, just to keep from getting sacked. Is that really the kind of effort you want to put in? Is that really the kind of lifestyle you want? Is that really the kind of person you want to be? I don't think it is. So put the most effort in you can to your job. The next one is have strong boundaries. Now, a lot of people really struggle with this. They have the disease to please. The disease to please, right? People pleasing, right? They want to do everything for everyone else and then victim mindset themselves into, I do everything for everyone else. I don't have time for me or whatever, right? Boundaries is key to being confident. I recently had an altercation with a friend of mine that we've been friends with for a long time, probably about 5 years. But every time she gets drunk and our little group of friends, she is aggressive. She's not very nice. She always stirs the pot. She always causes drama. One time I did go off the rails on her and I did have a shouting match with her and I was like, you are this, you shouldn't do this kind of thing. Probably wasn't the best way to handle it, but you know, we're only human. But this time is we had to put our boundaries down. I had to put my boundaries down and say, look, I'm not hanging out with you while you drink. I'm not going to be a part of this drama that you seem addicted to. That's my boundary line. It's like, you're not my friend, you're not a true friend, blah, 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 you should be doing this. It's like, whoa, I don't care. I don't care. If you're going to bring that into my life, I'm not going to let you be a part of it. Having boundaries is key. You want to, you know, boundaries is what you're willing to tolerate in your life. And if you just get pushed from pillar to post, everyone can break you, everyone can do this to you, everyone can say this to you. It's like, where's your sense of self-worth? Where's your sense of value? You'll notice people who have strong boundaries where they're like, no, that's unacceptable. I don't like that. Don't do that. Do not say that around me. Don't bring that into my life. I don't need this. If you're not going to bring, you know, happiness into my life, if you're not going to bring good energy, get out. You don't need that. You need to be protective of your values, of your boundaries. So boundaries really come to what's valuable to you. What do you value most in your life? So if you can get your boundaries sorted, you know, you're key. So have a think about this after this video. What kind of boundaries do you have in place currently? What needs to be strengthened? What is coming into your life that shouldn't be there? And where do you need to set those boundaries? Because people will respect you more when you have boundaries. Even if they don't like it, they will respect you for it. And they will wish that they had those kind of boundaries. And the final point on this is relax. Take the pressure off. You're not always going to be the best in every situation. You're going to, you know, the classic example of when you go to a restaurant and the waiter says, enjoy your food. And you go, you too. Like, you're always going to mess up in little ways. It doesn't mean you're unconfident. It just means that you had a brain fart, right? Take the pressure off. My old mentor used to say, perfection is the lowest standard. Everyone tries to aim for perfection and ends up doing nothing. Perfection is the lowest standard. So don't compete with other people as well when it comes to this. Don't always compare yourself to others. I know it's hard with social media to, you know, when you see other people living a great life, but for the most part, everyone still takes a shit. Everyone still picks the nose. Everyone's still a little bit of a dirty tramp. You know what I mean? Everyone has weird thoughts. Everyone's a little bit weird. And when you realize that, when you realize people are just people, regardless of follow account on social media, regardless of one video that you saw of them living a great life in Bali or whatever, people are still people. Yes, they might be further ahead in some areas, but people are still people. There's no need to compete. If you want to look at people on social media, use them for inspiration, not competition. Use them for inspiration, not competition. That's one of the best ways to get ahead, is to say, okay, they're living a life that I really want to live. They seem really confident. What do they do in their daily life? What are they doing, you know, consistently that I can be inspired by, that I can replicate and get to that level? If that's really where you want to go with that, fair enough, go and do it. But don't compete and just take some of the pressure off. When you go in these situations where you don't feel confident, don't worry about it. And that's easy advice, don't fucking worry about it. But seriously, relax. And what will happen is when you relax, when you slow down your breathing, when you slow down your words, a confidence will rise naturally anyway. I'm not always the loudest in social situations. I'm not always the be all and end all. Yeah, I make, you know, a lot of jokes and I like to be, you know, in there. I like to make sure everyone's included. But you know, it's not always about me. I take some of the pressure off. I let other people take over for a change. I'm not ego driven. I don't need to be the center of attention. Chill into it. And just remember that it is key and perfection is the lowest standard. But I've saved the best to last. If you're still watching this, which I hope you are, the best advice I was ever given is a mindset shift that you have to remember. So it's something that every time a negative thought comes up, every time a worry comes up, every time you don't feel like you can do something, this is the thought. This is the thought process I want you to go for. And it's N-R-Y-N-E. It'll be on the bottom of the screen. N-R-Y-N-E. And that stands for no reason you're not enough. There's no reason you're not enough. And I said to my mentor, when he first said this to me, I said, well, I think of plenty of reasons why I'm not enough. And he said, nope, it's a mindset shift. Whenever you get those thoughts of I'm not good enough, I'm shit, I'm crap, I'm this, I'm that, no reason you're not enough. N-R-Y-N-E. And it's amazing how many times in our lives opportunities come to us and we go, I'm not good enough for this. What's the point in trying? N-R-Y-N-E. Just go for it anyway. Who gives a shit? What's the result? If you don't even try, like, you're not going to get anywhere. So why not try? Like, what's the point in not trying? Like, you ever thought about that? What's the point in not trying? Because I'm shit, I'm this. Are you actually shit? Or is there really no reason you're not enough? So I'm curious, what was your biggest takeaway from this? Let me know in the comments below, what was your biggest takeaway? And if there's anything else you want more advice on, please drop me a message or comment below. And I will see you very soon, guys. Have a tremendous rest of your day.